What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLean, and I'm a music producer. So today, going all the way back to Calm, first thing I ever did, or the very first full album breakdown I ever did. But as a lot of you know, like, I've only done the production side of things, but with this, I'm actually going to do the lyrics. And I'm going to kind of do a couple different things. I'm going to explain, like, how the lyrics affect the production. You know, obviously, like, content of the lyrics, that kind of a thing, which one of the reasons I don't really talk about that very often is because it's mostly, like, guesstimates, you know, like, yeah, I have no idea really and truly what the songs are about, but I can kind of tell you how things are put together, why they're that way, or maybe, like, you know, perspectives and things. I don't know. This is the first time I'm doing this. Actually, I did one on the Patreon, but probably not as in-depth as this, so should be fun. Before we get started, though, as always, please give me a like, give me a subscribe if you enjoyed the channel. I'm going to put my social media up top. Please give me a follow on Instagram or Twitter, and, yeah, send messages, you know, drop comments, give me suggestions for other things that you want to hear, want to see. If you like this idea, I'm definitely thinking about doing more, so let me know if you like it. Also, I've been putting more stuff on the Patreon. I'm saying this like every video now because it's helping so much for the channel. There's a $2 option now, and I'll put like a screenshot of something that I'm gonna upload today. So it's like I'll do a review here or something like that, and I'll do like the exact same artist and put one on Patreon that day. So please go check it out. Please help support the channel. It means a ton. And I think that's pretty much all that stuff. Also, please tune in for the producer tomorrow at 5 o'clock. Yeah, it's gonna be fun. I'm gonna premiere it. So let's jump in. And what I'm gonna do is probably like I'm not gonna read the lyrics out loud like I have done in past videos. I'm gonna go ahead and like let the song play and pause and talk about like some of the different aspects of the lyrics and again like how they're affecting everything or if I see like patterns, that sort of a thing. So let's start with Red Desert. Gosh, I listened to this album a few times now. I love it.
Red, red desert, heal our blues. I dive deeper for you. What a blessing to feel your love. Twilight moments with you.
I've been asleep so long. So far away.
So already something kind of interesting and cool is the perspective switch. So like you have, and this ties into the production perfectly. So like for that first chorus, you have like red, red desert, heal our blues. It's the our blues, you know. So you have all the stacked vocals because it's all of them sort of speaking to the desert. And I don't know why every time I hear it, I hear red, dead desert, but it's red, red desert. So then it switches on the verse and it goes to like an actual, like his perspective, you know what I mean? Just a solo perspective, which is cool. And you'll notice throughout the song, like that kind of changes. And anytime, well, you'll see, we'll talk about it in a second.
Visions I see are strong. I hear what they say. Won't you leave all your fears at the edge of the world? I'll tell you.
Another thing, like, he, for that little pre-chorus, like, for a pre-chorus, you kind of want to build a little bit of tension, so to ask, you know, tell me, would you pack up all your bags, stay true to North, you know, you're asking a question, so it creates a little bit of that tension. Also, it's almost like, it's very Doors, it's like very the Doors, because they used to talk about, like, Jim Morrison's lyrics were amazing, and he used to talk about, like, the desert, and, like, going out into the desert, and, like, having visions, and, like, you know, they would actually go out and do a lot of other things, but, yeah, it's kind of crazy how it almost feels like that's sort of a reoccurring theme. The desert is somewhere that you go to, like, find yourself. It's a very spiritual thing. And that's also why you have, like, what a blessing to feel your love, you know, twilight moments with you, which I love that line.
Doesn't take too long.
there's that harmony on top of it, because now it's a weir instead of just him. So, you know, you're playing off the production a little bit there as well.
They're begging to stay. Tell me, would you back up or you backstage? Should have known you're the only one I'd do this for. Red, red desert. Heal our blues. I'd dive deeper for you. What a blessing to feel your love.
Another thing I do want to say here is, like, your syllable counts are super important. You know, you kind of want to mirror them as much as possible in the different, like, little sections. And I'll kind of start breaking down some of those in other songs, so it's not, like, all kind of shoved into one, all these concepts. But, like, you have red, red desert, heal our blues. Like, red, red desert, heal our blues. So they're kind of, they're mirroring each other melodically a little bit. So, like, red, red desert, heal our blues. So, okay, it's like melodic syllables. That's the thing that I was going to talk about. It's like melodic syllables, not normal like syllables. So, like, the blues is not just, like, one syllable. Like, it kind of, it's a weird thing to explain. Blues is two syllables when sung. It's like, heal our blues, or blues. It could be one or two. It kind of sits right in between. So you sort of have to have this kind of ear for it, if that makes sense. But I'll hopefully help you guys kind of point them out. Talking about the desert, and again, it reminds me of the Doors. It's like very it's very Native American, it's very, like, spiritual, that kind of a thing, even though it's, like, obviously, you know, the Australia desert. But, like, that's why, you know, with the drums and everything, whenever they were making the track, they're probably like, okay, let's do something that feels, you know, kind of like Native American, like that spiritual Native American thing, like basically, what I'm trying to get to is, like, having those huge, like, taiko drums that almost feel like war drums, you know what I mean? Like, it kind of gives you that sort of a feeling. And honestly, it's why the melody and the lyrics, they tie in together, like, extremely, they're very interconnected. Like I said, I'm trying to kind of get some of these straight in my head so I can explain them. I'm so used to explaining the other stuff now. You can have a melody that can make somebody feel, in a production, that makes it feel like the desert, but that's just accentuating the lyrics, and that's exactly what they're doing here with the grit on the guitar and the you know, the huge taiko drums and all that stuff. And we'll dive deep into it. Dive deep. Playing off of the like the gospel idea. That's what's making you feel that way, because you have the huge vocals in the back, like all of the stacked vocals, and it feels like a gospel choir almost, which is like the blues, you know, the blessing, like the little bit of darkness, like that kind of a tinge to it.
You're the only one I do this for.
Let's keep going. Let's go to No Shame.
Angel, with the gun. my direction.
Also, one more thing I do want to note, like, I'm on Genius Lyrics, but I'm not going to read the stuff on the side, because I was just looking at that, and I'm like, no, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to have my interpretation of it, because I think that's, I don't want it to be affected. You know what I mean? I kind of want to see where my brain sort of goes.
Giving me affection, love you said it all. Won't you give it a chance, center of attention. Won't you ask me any questions? You got me now, now, now. Swallow me down, 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 down. I only like dropping cameras of fashion. Never enough for no satisfaction. Got no shame.
So like here, this is kind of cool because that is the chorus. You have words that are easy to like, easy to hit the consonants and get off of it, you know. I only light up when cameras are flashing, never enough and no satisfaction. The T's and like the F and stuff like that, like you, see cameras like the C, so like a little bit harder consonants, you know, and that's why the melody ended up going where it was, which is kind of interesting. It doesn't really necessarily play off the lyric as much as, I guess it kind of does.
I love the way it's been in my name.
Thing is his vocal's super far forward, and the reason it's far forward is because of the context. Yeah, well, it might not be the exact reason, but it still plays off of the context of this, because he's not talking about something in the future, nothing in the past, so it's like right now, you know, it's like he's in front of you talking, so you're not gonna have this big reverb on his vocal, nothing like that. It's gonna feel like he's literally standing in front of you talking about something that's happening to him at that moment in time.
You'll always be forgiven. Don't wanna place me when you crave something sweeter than the words I left in your mouth. Go on and spit me out. I only light up when cameras are flashing. Never enough for no satisfaction. Got no shame. I love the way you scream in my name. Thinking about grief to get the reaction. Getting in my face, you got the impression.
So another thing, like as I was, I did look at the thing on this one, like that's on the side, you know, where they were kind of talk about it. And at first I thought this was maybe about like a forbidden love kind of a thing, which it might be a double play. You know, you never know. Whenever artists do write this stuff and they say what a song is about, really and truly, I'm gonna be completely honest with you, most of the time there's another meaning under it that they do not tell anyone. I mean, I'm sure you guys pretty much know that, but sometimes it's like almost the complete opposite of what you think, and they do it on purpose because it's almost fun. You know, I can't tell you how many songs I've written and like I'll tell somebody what it's about and that's not what it's about at all, but if it works for it. Sometimes you just have to kind of like keep that stuff to yourself. You know, you never want to give anybody the satisfaction of knowing that you wrote a song about them. But anyways, so like I was thinking this is actually like about a maybe somebody else, like significant other kind of a thing, you know. And yeah, like the forbidden love, it almost feels like it. And you just keep coming back. See there, obviously you're playing the melody off of down, down, down.
Swallow me down, 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 down.
So like it feels like everything is moving down. You also put a little bit more reverb on it, so it almost feels like you're literally just going down into this hole.
I love the way you scream in my name.
happening with the guitar as well. It feels like you're falling down a hole, you know, huge reverb on the guitar, everything like that. So it's playing. I know that was the last literally line of the song. And the other thing is, it like right there at the very end, let me pull it back for a second. It makes it feel like you're falling down this hole, and then suddenly you pull all that verb out, you just have the vocal right up front in your face, and it's almost like, you know, hold on, pull it right back. You know what I mean? Like, pull myself back to reality kind of a deal. Okay, so. Alright, so let's go to old me.
Shout out to the old me and everything he showed me. Glad you didn't listen when the world was trying to slow me. No one could control me, left my lovers lonely. Had to fuck it up before I really got to know me. Never and not alone, anywhere you wanna go.
Also, these things I'm talking about are not like set rules. Like, if you're talking about something in the past or in the future, you don't have to have reverb on it. They're more like tools, you know? Like, if you kind of want to make it feel a little bit more that way, you can pull that out of your toolbox and, like, throw it on, you know, in the production, and it helps. And that's all you're doing.
Woke up in the morning wearing someone else's clothes. Pictures in my phone with people I don't know. Woke up in the morning, how the hell did I make it home? And they wondered how long I could keep it up. But I wondered if I'd ever get enough. And I did some shit I never should have done.
Although, you know, you do have like the big reverbs and stuff like that on the most of the instrumentation, aside from the drums that are sort of right up front with the vocal. So maybe that's kind of the play there, you know. And I wonder, because, you know, you're thinking, and they wondered how long I could keep it up. Well, I wondered if I'd ever get enough. Ooh, that would make kind of sense too, because like you want to refer to somebody else and the band is playing. You know, and then he's singing, so like you have the band a little bit farther away and then him up front, kind of a thing, because they're wondering and then he's right there.
I do it all up. Shout out to the old me and everything you showed me. Glad you didn't listen when the world was trying to slow me. No one could control me, left my lovers lonely. Had to fuck it up before I really got to know me.
Too, it's almost like you know, like okay, so here you actually kind of come back to the present. You know, I actually have to think about these things just a little bit more in depth before I say them. So like verse two, you know, another round, here we go, going round or going in blow for blow, that kind of a thing. You're right there in front of, you know, present time again, but on that chorus you were a little bit farther away. So like the cut in, you know, he cuts in like immediately with that verse. Another round, here we go, going in blow for blow, like right at the very end. So there's no space in between, and it might just be kind of, again, that snap back to reality sort of a thing, you know, from the past.
I take the punches that I throw. I'm constantly reminded of all the compromises by the people from the past who have a hard time letting go.
Very thank you next, because except it's with you, you know, like you can't really regret the things that you did, but they made you who you are.
Could control me, left my lovers lonely. Had to fuck it up before I really got to know me.
The first time I heard this, I thought that he said something else, and I was just looking to see what I had written down, because it made me think of, like, almost, I almost wish they had played off of, like, Knocking on Heaven's Door, which is cool. Like, Devil at My Door got me knocking on the other side. But there was something I had added in, and I can't remember what it was. Oh, but it was sick. It was so killer. I don't know. Yeah, let's keep going. So the other thing I was going to say, though, too, they put the high harmony in over his vocal there in, like, it might have been, like, the third or something like that, or maybe it was, like, the... I don't want to say, because I don't 100% know what the harmony was, but it wasn't like a one, or like a one, a three, or a five, yeah, that's what I was getting to. It wasn't like a one, or three, or a five, which is like the do, mi, so, those very, which feel really good. Instead, it was something that feels a little off, because it's like Devil at My Door, you know, so you want it to have a little bit of tension there. You're not a hero, shout out to the old me, and everything you showed me, glad you didn't listen when the world was trying to slow me, no one could control me, left my lovers lonely, had to fuck it up before I really got to know me. This album is just so solid. Alright. Let's keep going. Let's go to Easier. Is it easier to stay? Is it easier to go? I don't wanna know. But I know that I'm never ever gonna change. And you know you don't want it any other way. Why do we always gotta run away? And we wind up in the same place. It's like we're looking for the same thing, yeah. Do we really gotta do? Obviously, I don't know, I probably don't even have to say it, but same thing, repeating it twice, you know, is just a playoff of the lyric. Ride it with all your friends around. In the morning we can work it out, work it out. I love you so much that I hate you. Right now it's so hard to blame you. You're so damn beautiful. It's so damn beautiful. Is it easier to stay? Is it easier to go? I don't wanna know. So this actually takes advantage of one of the best things you can do with lyrics, and that's you have three things generally that you want to do for a chorus. You either want to ask a question, you want to say something like outrageous almost, or you want to tell somebody to do something. And here it's the question, that is it easier to stay? Is it easier to go? And then he's answering himself with the I don't want to know. It's also, everything is very introspective, but it's still conversational. It's like, it's almost like having a conversation with himself, you know, and that's kind of why you get this darker feel to it. This whole first half of this album is super dark. But I know that I'm never ever gonna change, and you know that you're always gonna stay the same. Is it easier to stay? Every time that you say you're gonna leave, that's when you get the very best of me. See, this is exactly kind of almost the same theme as some of the last couple, you know, it's just like self-depreciation, you know what I mean? Like, you just kind of keep doing it to yourself, and here it's two people doing it to them at, like, their relationship, you know, and they both know it, but they're fine with it. They just keep kind of doing it, going around in that same circle over and over again. You know we need it like the air we breathe, air we breathe, yeah. I love you so much that I hate you. Right now it's so hard to blame you, 'cause you're so damn beautiful. It's so damn beautiful. I was one of those kids that had to, like, do this in... But I was never the greatest at math, ever. I love it, but, like, I was never great at it. Is it easier to stay? And that's what I was doing. I was just counting syllables. Because it was like the I love you so much that I hate you. Right now it's so hard to blame you. Because you're so damn beautiful. So, like, you're playing, you have like 8-7-7. And then the repeat of the little last line. Which actually is kind of cool. So they say in conversation. I just realized this. So they say in conversation, one of the best ways to keep a conversation going is literally just repeat the last three words that somebody says. And that happens actually a lot in music now that I'm thinking about it. You'll take the last three words of a line and then just do that part again. And it keeps things kind of going because it opens people up. Here, so you actually have kind of it's the bridge, you know, so you want the bridge to feel like it's a little bit farther away, like it's like that secondary thought, and that's exactly what's happening here. So you put a little reverb on it, you know, and you kind of play off of that lyric, the in the hardest part of all, it's the only bit to fall, and that fall feels like it's almost falling a little bit because of the verb, because it feels a little bit farther away.
And then pull it back. Is it easier to stay? Is it easier to go? I don't wanna know. But I know that I'm never ever gonna change. And you know that you're always gonna stay the same.
Pretty killer. I love that song so much. All right, so let's go to Teeth. This is Teeth. I love it.
Some days you're the only thing I know. Only thing that's burning when the nights grow cold. Can't look away, can't look away. Beg you to stay, beg you to stay, yeah. Sometimes you're a stranger in my bed. Don't know if you love me or you want me dead. Push me away, push me away. Then beg me to stay, beg me to stay, yeah. Call me in the morning to apologize.
So I just realized something, actually a couple little things. One, for the pre-chorus, you have that like same line, same line, same line, and then the tail, but like for that third line, you kind of do want it to just be a little bit different than the previous two, but it's still playing off of the same melody, and that's exactly what they're doing here. And it's just kind of important whenever you're writing lyrics to pay attention to, like, you know, your syllable counts and how everything is kind of mirroring other ones, you know, because eventually it is going to mirror your melody, or your melody is going to reflect how your lyrics were written, you know? And you kind of do want to play off of that and have at least some kind of structure in mind. I'll talk about the other thing in a few. I want to listen a little bit more and see if I'm right.
Don't know if I'm gonna make it out alive. Fight so dirty, but your love so sweet. Talk so pretty, but your heart top tea.
See, that's the only line that throws me a little bit. This sometimes when I look at you, I see my wife. But I was gonna say, honestly, you know what this feels like and sounds like more or less to me? It could be taken as both. It almost sounds like a conversation with himself, like in the demon that's in him. You know what I mean? Like, you know, he fights so dirty, but then he loves so sweet, kind of a thing, and talks so pretty, but his heart actually has teeth. And he's talking about the devil that's inside him, so the late night devil, put your hands on me, because it grabs you, you know, maybe later at night, or maybe you drink a little bit and it happens, or like, you know, and then you do have that, call me in the morning to apologize, every little lie gives me butterflies. It's like telling lies to yourself, you know, and you wake up in the morning, you're like, why did I do that? What kind of person am I, you know? And then something in the way you're looking through my eyes as well, it's like the demons looking out could be possible. Oh, that'd be crazy.
I've been you down into somebody I don't know, and you push me away, yeah. Call me in the morning to apologize. Every little lie gives me butterflies.
noticed the production is playing off of the lyric a little bit. You have the fight so dirty, but your love so sweet, sweet. That's higher. Gosh, that's a weird note. But anyways, you have like the dirty bass, you have the dirty guitars, you have even like the dirty, like distorted drums here that's giving it that grit, that oomph that it needs, but it's playing off of the lyric, you know, you're building the production around it.
So pretty, but
that could just be him standing in front of a mirror looking at the things that he's done to himself, you know? Like, oh my gosh, it would just be so cool. It's just the one line that makes me think that, you know, it is a relationship thing. Also, the huzz, like the on the snare is kind of like, you know, the heavy breathing kind of a thing. Like you're trying to deal with it, you know, like you, your heart increases, like heart rate increases, that kind of a thing. And you're feeling that a little bit more.
Heart in my hand, still beating. Fight so dirty, but your love so sweet. Talk so pretty, but your heart got tea. Late night devil, put your hands on me. And
it's like breathe out, just try and breathe out, try and breathe out.
Never, never, ever let go. Fight so dirty, but your love so sweet. Talk so pretty, but your heart.
That this is in gives it that dark feel as well, you know, and that's why like all of those the little like solos and stuff like that that he's doing on guitar kind of just accentuate it. Almost feels very like Halloween, you know, or like Bullet for My Valentine or something like that. Yeah. Actually, it's a very like Avenged Sevenfold tone. Okay. So let's keep going. Let's go to Wildflower.
Wild
Everything just turns.
Wildflower. I hear you calling out my name. I love the sound. I love the taste. And I can see it in your face. You got a side you can't explain.
And see here you have the same syllable counts. Also, something to note, you can tell that Callum wrote these lyrics. I'm pretty sure he was the one that wrote the lyrics. But everything just switches over because it's a different person's mentality. It's amazing what two people can be going through at the same time. You know, one person's way over on this side of the spectrum and another person's here. Because this is like, it's very happy, you know, and it's very like, it's very lovey. Kind of a thing.
You wanna be closer. I love it when you wear your head down over your shoulder. Cause I wanna hold you. Cause I know where tonight is going. You're the only one who makes me. Every time we tell you what I like. My
cool with the melody, you know, you have a fatal love song, like that fatal actually kind of plays a little bit off of like a tension note, and because of the word fatal, you know, it's the one kind of dark little line that's there. Also, whenever they do like the wildflower thing, it's stacked vocals because it kind of mimics, you know, a flower. You know, you have like all the petals on a flower, so you can almost imagine like that many voices. That's why you're playing off of it. You kind of have to think weird and different and very symbolically whenever you're doing the production for this stuff.
You're the only one who makes me every time we I see the color in your face. It makes me smile, it makes me shake. I see the shadow in my brain, and I like its look, and I like its shape.
There's the mirror again.
You're telling me, telling me, telling me you wanna come over. You wanna be, wanna be, wanna be, wanna be closer. I love the way you wear your head down over your shoulder.
It's actually more of like a happier feeling, you know? And when it is a happier feeling like this, your best bet is to have something that's a little bit more upbeat. So you have a lot of the music, you know, kind of doing like a... But then you're playing a lot of like 16th notes, that sort of a thing, because it almost sort of gets your heart moving, gets your heart racing.
Cause I wanna hold you. Cause I know where tonight is going. You're the only one who makes me.
Yourself when you're writing and you're doing production as well. If you actually, you could just go with the just writing if you don't have like a produced track. But something I try and go by as well is like, if you just sing the melody without the words, do you get the same feeling out of the song? And if you do, then you know you have something that's cohesive and it's right. But you need that same feeling. You have to get the feeling across with just the melody, and then you throw in the words and it just throws it over the top. That's what makes an incredible song. That's what takes a great demo and makes it into an incredible song. And that's kind of what gives it a little bit of the happier vibe too. There isn't a lot of like little production stuff on this one because it's not trying to be super clever. It's just trying to be like a good song, you know, but it works.
No, you are my favorite fantasy. A fair love song. Waterfall is overflowing. You're the only one who makes me. Every time we take my
You can kind of feel that like spreading of a flower. It's crazy. Okay. Let's go to Best Years. Oh, God, I love this song. It's in my head all the time.
You got a million reasons to hesitate. But darling, the future's better than yesterday.
Already, future, yesterday, talking about like the past, like, you know, the past and the, yeah, past and the future. I was gonna say paths. You got me. But that's why you have a little bit of the verb on it and stuff like that. But it's not this huge verb because he's still talking to someone, you know, right then and there.
I wasted so much time on people that reminded me of you. Gave you a million reasons to walk away.
And you also have this, like, syllable-wise, you know, you have, like, same syllable line, and then you have the change, and then you go back to the original kind of, structure, you know? It's almost like the same line, tail thing that I talk about all the time, but you kind of have to combine those into one concept.
But I bet I was out of the mess, and all the broken pieces I make up for of your tears. I'll give you the best. Yeah. wanna hold your head when you drink too much.
Something else that's interesting about this is, like, you know, the way that he's talking and what he's trying to get across is, you know, I'll give you the best years. It's almost like kind of trying to convince somebody. And so you have these strings in the back, and you have the music just creating this sort of tension. You know, like if somebody was sitting there telling you, you know, I'll give you the best years, you know, past love, it's burned out like a cigarette, you know, I promise you won't regret, you're gonna kind of be a little bit on edge. And then it cuts it out and it brings it back down to the verse, and it's like the things that he wants to do, and then it's more like a little bit sweeter, you know? It's not so, I'm trying to think of the word for it. It's not so forward.
Carry you home when you cannot stand up. You did all these things for me when I was half a man for you. I wanna hold your hand while we're growing up. But I'll build a house out of the mess, and all the broken pieces I'll make up for of your tears. I'll give you the best years. I'll give you the best years. Best love burned out like a cigarette. I promise, darling, you won't regret the best years.
Hear the strings? That's what I was talking about on the last one. You can hear they're like playing sort of that, it's not the root, you know? The root would kind of make it feel really nice and homey, but that's not what they're doing. And that's why it's moving out as well. And then the faraway guitar, all that stuff, the very U2 feel makes it feel like this huge thing, because the future is a massive, like, a massive if, a huge maybe. Yeah, you just don't 100% know. So you have that big reverb, that like uncertainty, that far away feeling. A little bit more forward, because they kind of want to accentuate, you know, I am right in front of your face, I'm talking to you.
Yes. Best love and not like a cigarette. I promise, darling, you won't regret the best years. I'll give you the best years.
I never noticed Michael's part on that. Oh my gosh. That makes sense. That's why that kind of has that little bit of a contrast. It's because of the difference in tones. Huh. Okay, let's keep going. So, not in the same way.
Drink all night, never sleep. You say go, I won't leave. I love you, you love me,
but not in the same way.
Rip my heart out and leave on the floor, watch me bleed. I love you, you love me,
but not in the same way.
Not today, mascara's running down your face again.
So here you can see the difference in like the syllable counts between like the chorus and the verses as well. You know, so they're not all on the same like pentameter, you know, the same kind of flow. You want it to feel like it's changing, you know? You have something super rhythmic, and then you have something kind of a little less rhythmic. It's like right in between for this verse, if I remember right. Oh yeah, it's super rhythmic for actually the pre-chorus. So those are the three basically, like, because you want three almost tiers to it, you know? So like you have really, really rhythmic here, you have kind of rhythmic, which is the chorus, and then you have a little bit less like rhythmic than that for the verses.
I can feel it coming down on me. Hurricane insert name. We're good at this game.
And you can see because of like how long the lines are too, you can kind of figure that out because that's the way that you would read it.
Game. We fuck, we fight, then you call me a psycho. I walk in the door, but you won't let me let go. Say go, I won't leave. I love you, you love me,
but not in the same way.
Rip my heart out and leave on the floor. Watch me bleed. I love.
whenever I first broke down this one, if I remember correctly, I talked about how, like, it almost feels like you're trying to get all the words out, trying to get them all out. And I guessed that, I guessed that they had written everything very quickly, and apparently they wrote it very fast, like everybody said. I was right. And you can tell because of the way that the lyrics are written, you know, and the way that the music is put together, it feels like you can't get all the words out fast enough. You know, they're just kind of coming to you. You have so much to say, and trying to fit it all in as quickly as you possibly can. You love me tonight, the same way. My heart ought to lean on the floor. Watch me bleed. I love you. You love me tonight, the same way. Not today. I'm waking up to my mistakes again. I know you love to point them out. Baby, I'm sick of sadness, and you're sick of sadness. We're good at this game. We fuck and we fight, then you call me a psycho. I walk out the door, we don't wanna live and let go. Turn right around through a rocky window. But I can't forget you, and I always let you. Drink all night, never sleep. You say go, I won't leave. I love you, you love me tonight. So that, but not in the same way, is a little bit like sort of the aside from it all. But notice that, you know, on the bass, you're actually playing the same thing the entire song, and it's the melody that over and over and over and over again, and then the melody mimics that, and you have the melodies like constantly repeating, and it almost just feels like, basically the point I'm getting to, everything is just always going in this circle. You know, it never really ends. It's just a vicious cycle. Rip my heart out and leave on the floor. Watch me bleed. I love you. You love me. They go, I won't leave. I love you, you love me tonight, the same way. Rip my heart out and lean on the floor. Watch me bleed. I love you, you love me tonight, the same way. Tonight, the same way. Tonight, the same way. I don't ever wanna lie to you, but I can't say no. But you know how to hurt me too. And the dark with black and white. In the morning, colorblind. You know, he's also using a lot of, like, rhyme schemes that are kind of easy to flow. You know, sometimes when you get into that mode, it's because, and you're just writing, it's because the rhyme scheme is easy to go to. There's a lot of words and a lot of, it's just easier to get your idea out because there's so many words you can use as rhymes, if that makes sense, you know. Because for a lot of them, there's very, it's a very set number of words, and sometimes you get stuck because of that. If you're up with everybody, then everything's up. When you tell me you love me, then you wanna leave me. Pouring your pills on the sink, saying it's not what you think. Don't know if I love you, don't know if I hate you. But I can't forget you, and I'll always let you. Drink all night, never sleep. You say go, I won't leave. I love you, you love me. Rip my heart out and leave on the floor. Watch me bleed. I love you, you love me. But not in the same way. Drink all night, never sleep. You say go, I won't leave. I wonder what the most common, I'm thinking about it now. These are some things, like, as I'm breaking down these, I'm learning some new stuff as well. I wonder what the most common, commonly, like, rhymed word is. You know what I mean? A rhymed phonetic is. You, you love me, but not in the same way. Rip my heart out and leave. Okay, so yeah, it's E. It's the E sound. Apparently there's like 937 words that rhyme with, they said the word B. So I'm gonna keep an eye out for that in other songs from now on, because that's interesting. And I wonder if that does kind of play into how quickly songs are written, you know? Okay, so let's keep going. Let's get to Lover of Mine. Thank you.
passing away. Hope and I pray, darling, that you will stay. Butterfly lies, chase them away.
So, like, you have that, you know, chase them away, that kind of a thing, or you're hoping and you're praying, so you have that reverb, kind of the tail on the end of his vocal that's just playing off of that lyric a little bit, you know? It feels like it's sort of moving away, you know, or the hope, because hope is a very far away concept.
Dance around the living room, lose me in the sight of you. I've seen the red, I've seen the blue. Take all I need deep to where your secrets are, where we've been a thousand times. Swallow every single lie. Take all of me. I'll never give you away, cause I've already made that mistake. If my name never fell off your lips again, I know it'd be such a shame. You're the only thing that I think I got right. I'll never give you away, cause I've already made that mistake. Overnight, I know you're gone.
Interesting, so there again, you have that same kind of, like, darkness that comes in because of, it's like the falling, you know, kind of a darkness. Because he's looking back on himself and looking back at a lot of this stuff. I was writing something down, and so I lost myself for a second, because I had this idea that actually, like, hope isn't something that exists in the present or for the present. It exists for the future, and you can't have hope for the past either.
Watch the world fall from your eyes.
Yeah, so that I watch the world fall from your eyes, you know, that kind of a thing. It's darker, so you have that that dirty, dirty bass that comes in under everything and just gives it this grit. You're kind of just playing off the reverb. There isn't a lot really and truly that's playing, like, production wise here off of the lyric.
Off your lips again. I know it'd be such a shame when I take a look at my life and all of my crimes. You're the only
That's cool too, because you have the already made, and then he says already made the mistake again, because it's the already done, you know, you say it twice. What's funny too is actually the lyric is very intimate, and the guitar is kind of what helps give it a little bit more of that intimate feel, because I don't think if that was there, it would be able to get the point across like it needs to. I think that was it. Yeah. Alright, let's keep going. It's been a while since I've heard that one. That's crazy. The Thin White Lies.
I don't feel your love.
Why? I just want to know why. Okay. Back to it.
that I don't ask too many questions. Doors that you're too much. When you show me my reflection, when the sun goes down, we all get lonely. Watch me as I disappear.
So even, oh, that's a perfect one for the reverb. You know, again, that is one of the best tools you can use for the production, the lyric, to tie them together, and that disappear, throwing the big reverb on it, kind of makes it feel like everything is floating away. And everything is actually a little bit darker here too, you know. It's a very dark album. But I don't fear your love, I don't ask too many questions, you know, the words are too much, when you show me my reflection, it's very internally, you know, just examining yourself. So it feels like it's a conversation, but it's a conversation with you.
These empty sounds and endless stories, so tell me what I wanna hear.
I still think that this isn't about a person. I think it's about him. I think it's him telling himself them white lies, you know, and then looking at himself internally.
You never call me out. You know exactly where I'm going. You got me by the mouth. She said she loved me, she don't show it.
See, and that's even like, it's him talking to himself about that. He's like, but she said she loved me and she don't show it. Like, that's like the true internal thought. It's not him talking up necessarily about I had it in my head and I was trying to get it out and it didn't come.
Watch me as I disappear. These empty sounds and endless stories, so tell me what I wanna hear.
Killing me slow with the words you wrote, the heart you broke, the heart you broke. Trying to write songs about the heart he broke, you know? And it's still about him and what he did.
Someone tell me who I was before. I don't really like me anymore. Anymore, anymore. Killing me slow with the words you wrote. Thought you broke, thought you broke, yeah. Calling my name, I don't wanna say. But I'm wide awake, I'm wide awake. Just one more taste of you, my love.
You know, I always get bothered by the way that they put commas in here, because really, like, there shouldn't be, I don't think there should be a comma, but just one more taste of you, my love. Like, oh, I guess maybe. I don't know, because I'm looking at it from more of a lyrical perspective, not necessarily like an English perspective, you know?
Someone tell me who I was before. I don't really like me anymore. Anymore.
And then you just repeat it at the very end again. See, there's so many little tiny clever things that, like, sometimes people don't pick up on, although I'm sure you guys do. Alright, so let's keep going. A Lonely Heart.
Your type of mind, so hard to find. Native of mine, you're just my kind.
There's the same syllable counts.
Down on my knees, I'll always follow. I promise you, until the end of time. Our house on fire,
inside you're hurting. If you leave me in the morning, I'll have such.
I forgot about this one. I don't know how I forgot about Lonely Heart, but I forgot about that.
Our house on fire, we're burning, but we dance inside you're hurting.
Like, oh, I love the feel on that. I know that's nothing really to do with the lyric, but still. Although, it is a little bit dancey, like a little bit more swung, and so it almost feels like, you know, the dance, like the house on fire we're burning, almost feels like the moving in circles kind of a thing because of the way that it's swung.
Such a lonely
heart. That's right. I remember this one now because I had the other idea for it where I wanted to take it halftime instead for the choruses. That's right.
Such a lonely heart. Oh, 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 oh. If you can't find another reason to stay, then I know I'm gonna always have a lonely, 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 lonely heart. Precious heart.
See, that's supposed to come down and feel like a heartbeat. That's why they took a lot of the highs out of the kick drum, you know, and made it feel like it's a little bit of a darker sound, so it feels like it's in your chest kind of pumping. And he talks about the heart immediately right there.
Watch it break. So I close my eyes while you walk away. Can I have a second chance? Can I have another dance? Can I start another life with you? Yeah. When I wake up in a haze and I haven't slept in days.
They add the reverb on for the word haze.
You're 1,000 miles away with such a lonely heart.
Like production stuff in this one that that again plays off of the lyric aside from like that beating heart. I'm gonna see if there's
anything. Lonely, ain't nothing new to me, nothing new to you.
Of maybe is like with all the group vocals, maybe it's like the different voices kind of in your head sort of trying to fight for survival, you know, like fight for space, you know, in your brain. I still think the halftime would have been great. I think it, and then you would have the little double hits too, so it would almost feel a little bit more like a heartbeat, because you can have the, you know, I don't know why that almost feels a little bit more like it does, even though a heartbeat is way more steady. People are probably like, what kind of heart do you have? What is it doing? All right, so let's go to the last song. Hi.
I hope you think of me high. I hope you think of me highly.
Obviously, he literally goes to the high notes for that and then goes a little bit higher for
highly. You're with someone else. I know your friends all lie. I know your friends don't like me. They want you for themselves. Today I called to tell you that I'm changing, but I don't think you have enough respect to see me try. I've been waking up in
in different spaces, but I think that my heart is built to last more than a night.
So the record cracking, like you have the vinyl, you know, crackle, kind of, it might just be for, you know, a little bit of, I was gonna say like a little bit of atmosphere, but it still plays off of it because it's like things just continuing to go around. Also, it's the end of the record, you know, so it's almost fitting. A lot of people kind of do that at the very end.
I need to stop letting me down, 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 down. I need to stop letting me down, 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 down. I hope you think of me high. I hope you think of me highly when you're with someone else.
Also, this is still so Beatles, it's unbelievable. And it's because of the, it just almost, their music, you know, it's funny, you can play off of a sound a little bit, because, like, their stuff was very introspective and very, like, but very personal. You know, the Beatles stuff always felt very personal. And so when you use sounds that are kind of like what the Beatles have, you end up getting the same feeling. People hear that and they don't really 100% realize why they feel the way that they do, but it's because of the feelings that they associate with another band or another sound. And that's just how music builds. So like here, it just accentuates that feeling a little bit more.
I know your friends all lie.
An introspective person.
I know your friends don't like me. They want you for them.
I was gonna say it's the detuned piano that makes it feel like the Beatles, excuse me.
I know I'll never meet your expectations, but the picture that you paint of me looks better in your mind. Every step I take with hesitation, and I always miss the memories of the mornings we were high. I need to stop letting me down.
It's also the ahs that they have. Like, those are super Beatles, too.
Down, 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 down. I need to stop letting me down, 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 down.
What's interesting about that is he actually goes the opposite way. Down, 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 down. So it ends on the down. Then down, 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 down. I guess it does still end on the down, but he goes high. So it feels like it's fighting itself.
I hope you think of me high. I hope you think of me highly when you're with someone else. I know your friends all lie. I know your friends don't like me. They want you for themselves. Da 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 da.
Love the Dawes too. Oh my gosh, how do I forget about some of this stuff? Like, I've listened to this album so many times, but like I'll just kind of listen to it as I'm walking around, and so I don't think about it as much.
When you're with someone else. Da 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 da.
So those are supposed to be like the friends as well, you know, everybody just wants their hands on this person, like, you know, jealousy, like, how humans are very selfish. I think that's the point here.
Want you for themselves. I hope you think of me high. I hope you think of me highly when you're with someone else.
And I love the note at the very end, too. It just makes it feel like it's not necessarily that. Actually, maybe just someone else. Yeah, it is the root. But, wow, still solid album. I mean, I love it. And it's cool jumping into it like this, too. You know, I really enjoy doing this. So if you guys want more of this stuff, please let me know. I'd be more than happy to maybe even break down Youngblood at some point. The album. Well, I'll do the artist, too. But, you know what I mean. Anyways, thanks for hanging around. And until next time, I'll catch you all later.